Part 5 of my QMK guide is about config files that change the way your custom keyboard works. Most keyboards will have a lot of the features you want enabled from the start, but it's useful to know that certain things need to be switched on in these files if you want to refer to them in your keymap. You can also reduce the size of your hex file by disabling features that you don't need. Some features of QMK can be adjusted from their defaults by editing these files. The two basic configuration files are config.h and rules.mk. If your keymap folder has these files, then they'll take priority over the same file which exists in the keyboard folder, as well as the QMK default. If you don't have a config.h, all you need to do is create a new file in your text editor and name it config.h. An easier way is to copy a config.h file from a different layout and start from there. Just make sure that the file you're copying is from the same keyboard. The QMK docs do a good job of describing what you can enable and disable here, so I won't go through all of it. You can define the number of levels you want for your backlit LEDs and adjust the timing of the backlit breathing effect. The config.h file is also where you can adjust the timing for tap keys and one-shots, as well as set how many times you have to tap a key to enable a toggle. Increments for adjusting the RGB LEDs and the sensitivity of mouse keys can also be fiddled with in this file. The rules.mk file has build information about your microprocessor and also some features that you might want to tweak. Don't just enable everything willy-nilly, as it will increase the size of your file. You can enable or disable mouse keys, Encro, RGB, and Unicode support. Check those QMK docs for the full details. The readme.md file isn't a config file and you don't have to have one, but it can be useful for anyone who is looking through your keymap and trying to make sense of it. You can also include links to photos or other resources that people might find useful, such as where to buy parts or see build guides. So now you know how to adjust the default settings of your keyboard, opening the door to a keyboard that works the way you want it to. Next episode, we'll tackle macros.